Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel that knows nothing. I am Jem and let's get to it. So today we are diving into a brand new challenge on this channel. It has been done previously on other channels. This is not one that I have created, but it's called the Save One, Drop One Challenge. Basically, I have a bunch of book names in here. They're kind of like favorites and not favorites at the same time, so it's a bit of a mix. And I'm gonna pick two out of here, and basically I have to pick one to save and one to just drop, yeet it into the void. And so let's just get started. So this is round number one. I'll give it a bit of a shuffle about. Okay, number one. We have Illuminate. Here it is. It's a thick boy. Basically, this is the story of like, kind of like from Chu's perspective. It's from a lot of different perspectives, and it's basically about how they've had to evacuate a planet, and there's a convoy of ships, and some not so great things are happening on the ships, but I'm not gonna say what, because I don't wanna spoil too much, and it's really cool the way that this story unfolds. It's like, very interesting. There's a bunch of different medias in this book. Highly can recommend this one. And we're gonna pick the second book that it's up against. It is up against this. Ooh, there's two there. This one is up against Of Fire and Stars. Okay, gonna grab that one. Bam, here we are. Fire and Stars. Basically, this is a sort of love triangle, forbidden love type situation. I think it's Mare is the one that is like in the arranged marriage with Dana's brother. I'm not really sure how to say her name, or what is the correct way to say her name. Basically, they end up falling in love, and one of them has a power that she probably shouldn't use, but uses it anyway. And there's a whole bunch of other stuff that happens within the story, but that is basically the gist of it. So now I have to pick between the two, and it's very, very hard. I'm not really sure what I expected from the first round, but I kind of am leaning towards Of Fire and Stars a little bit because it is way more the genre that I'm into. Like, I love my LGBT, like within like a fantastical world. I just think they're really cool. So I think I'm gonna pick Of Fire and Stars. I'm sorry, but I kind of don't feel bad about it at the same time. Now we are jumping into the second round of this challenge. We're gonna grab book number one. Ooh. Okay, we have this one. We have Not Your Sidekick. Okay. Not Your Sidekick by C.B. Lee, one of my favorite books because it's very underrated and it's LGBT and it's about superheroes, so it's got a lot of good factors going for it. And the story is basically about Jess, who is the daughter of these two very big superheroes, and it's her trying to discover her power and learn stuff about herself while all this other sort of villainy is going on in the background, and it's super good. Now we gotta pick the second book that it's gonna be up against. This will be interesting. Okay, this one is speaking to me. There's two of them, okay. And it is Once There Were Giants. Once There Were Giants is this picture book. I've loved it ever since I was a kid. My preschool gifted it to me when I left. And it's basically about the little baby on the front cover growing up and being a mom and like just, yeah, just going through life. It's very cute. And this has become very hard, and I don't know what to do. This doesn't feel fair. I think I made a mistake in picking favorite books because that, yeah. I think I'm gonna have to drop Not Your Sidekick for this one because this holds a lot of like sentimental value to me, and I really love it, and I don't know if I could live in a world without this book. I feel awful. Jumping in to the next round. Let's pick a book. Okay, we've got one. And it is Crooked Kingdom. Oh, okay. Crooked Kingdom by Leigh Bardugo. I had my issues with this book. Basically, it takes place after Six of Crows, where the crows have accomplished doing their heist. But terrible things are brewing in the barrel, and we're gonna see what it's up against. I have a feeling that you're gonna be dropped, and I don't even feel bad about it, okay? Next book that it's up against is, okay, that one just, you know, went into my hands. Mortal Engines. Oh, okay. Okay. Mortal Engines. Here it is. Mortal Engines follows the story of Tom and Hester and things that happen aboard the London and not on board the London, and about how this new sort of dystopian world works and some stuff that happened in the past when Valentine, this other character who is the villain, did some bad things, and bad things are happening. Ironically, I think Mortal Engines is going to get dropped because I love the characters in this a little bit too much. Mortal Engines is okay. This beats it, even though I thought it was pretty mediocre in compared to Six of Crows. Next round, pull the things from the pig. Okay, so we've got Cicada. I will grab that. It's just behind me right here. This is another picture book, another one that's very dear to my heart. Basically, it is about this little boy on the front, the cicada, and about how he hates the repetition of the workday and is very unhappy. It has a little bit of a dark premise to it, but is also really happy because he basically finds happiness at the end, which is what we all want, right? And the book that it is up against is... Ooh, that's two. Is, what is it up against? It's up against Gone. Here it is. Gone takes place in a world that has been domed, or like there is no escape. There is like a little part of the city that's been sectioned off in a giant dome, like in The Simpsons, which is kind of where this comes from, but then also another thing by Stephen King is where this comes from as well. Anyway, it follows the story of Sam, who is kind of the main character amongst all these other characters. And yeah, he's got superpowers now, as do a lot of the other characters. And basically, it's a child war zone, is the best way I can explain this book to you. And now I've got to decide between these two, which just, it's so weird comparing a picture book to a chapter book. Like, it's just... But we're doing it anyway, and I'm afraid that it's gotta be Gone with a very reluctant heart, because this one is just so sweet and it's just kind of like, I like it. Like, it just, I don't wanna lose it. I can't. I'm showing my true child in these videos because I picked the two picture books, but I kinda don't care. And next up, what do we have? We have... We have The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. Okay, this is gonna be hard. Here we are with The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. This is my favorite copy of it because it is illustrated. Anyway, so this follows the story of Peter, Susan, Edmund, and Lucy as they find a magical world through the back of the wardrobe, and they become the kings and queen of Narnia. Is a basic story, and they defeat evil, which we love. Okay, and it is up against Lore Olympus. Oh, holy fuck. Here it is, Lore Olympus. It's amazing. You can get it in stores now, not just online. I am only saying this because she's amazing, and look at the art. So pretty, and it smells amazing. I mean, you can't smell it, but still. Basically, this book is about the love story between Persephone and Hades, and it is mixed in with a bunch of other stuff as well. A bunch of the other gods are in it, and they have their own stories, and it's really good. And it is kind of dark, but I kind of like the twist that it takes. And yeah, it's really good, which I have so much love for them both that this is just really, really hard. And I think I'm gonna have to drop Narnia, because there are other ones, but The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe is not my favorite Narnia, so I don't feel so bad about that. I don't feel so bad about keeping this one, okay? It's fine. Everyone stop panicking. Next up we have, ooh, they came out together. Okay, I'm gonna put that one there. Next up we have Leah on the Offbeat, all right. Here we go, Leah on the Offbeat by Becky Arbatali, one of my favorite books. Basically, it's about this girl called Leah. She's on the front. She's in Simon versus the Homo Sapien Agenda. So if you haven't read that, you should probably read that before you read this one. Anyway, it is about sort of like after that, everyone's going off to college and making decisions, and Leah is just there making decisions, trying to get by, also is a little bit in love with someone, which I will not say who or what gender they are, because that is a massive spoiler and you should go and read the first book before you read this one, because hell yeah. And the next one we have is Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. Oh dear. Here is Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban, probably one of my favorite Harry Potters, along with Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. They are both my favorites, and so this becomes very hard because this is very good, because this is kind of like the turn where it gets a little bit darker and other things are happening and Harry meets Sirius, and that's very, you know, that's a very significant part of the story. And so I'm sorry, Leah, you are being yeeted. As much as JK Rowling is problematic, I do like this one. Okay, next round we have The Electric State. Okay, here it is, The Electric State, full of beautiful pictures, and I love it. Yes. Basically, it is about this character here, Michelle, and the little robot beside her. It's kind of like a very long-winded story, because it jumps around from the past to the present, and it's all very nice and good, but I kind of don't want to say too much, and I've also spoken about it before in other videos about what it's about. It's hard to explain what it's about, because I guess it's kind of like what you take from it is what it's really about. But yes, and it's up against, what is it up against? The Wicked King. Oh dear. The Wicked King by Holly Black is the second in the series of The Cruel Prince. Basically, it is after the events of The Cruel Prince, where Cardan is king and Jude is controlling him for a year and a day. So yes, that's very interesting. They have a very problematic yet kind of saucy relationship. I kind of really enjoy them, even though it's a little bit toxic. I don't support that. But yes, this is very good. The end left me very shocked. But this one has pretty pictures. This is so hard. I think it's gonna have to be, I don't know. I think it's gonna have to be The Wicked King, which I feel terrible in saying. Next round we have, ooh, they came out together. Next round we have Clockwork Angel. Okay. Here is Clockwork Angel. It's the first in the trilogy of the Infernal Devices. It's not as good as the others, I will say, but you know, it's an introduction book, basically. And it's introducing Tessa to the world of the Shadowhunters and, you know, having a love triangle pretty much right off the bat, which we love. You know, she's really meant to end up with Jem all along. Yeah. And it is up against Timeless. Here is Timeless, Diego and the Rangers of the Vast Atlantic. And basically this book is set in a whole bunch of different time periods. Like they all sort of like live together, like from really modern things to really like, you know, Victorian era. And they all have their different rules. Like they aren't really meant to, a lot of the Victorian people don't talk to the people that are kind of like living in the more modern era, and vice versa kind of. There's a lot going on in this book. Basically ends up being Diego trying to get his father back because his father goes missing and is presumed dead and a lot of other stuff. Anyway, it lines it up perfectly for another book at the end of this one because, you know, things happen. Anyway, versing these two books together, I think I'm gonna have to pick Timeless because it's got pretty pictures and a really, you know, different storyline, something new and not so basic. plus Clockwork Angel is not my favorite within the series. I definitely like Clockwork Prince better than this one, so I don't feel so bad. Done. And the next one we have The Viscount Who Loved Me. Oh, this is gonna be hard. Here it is, The Viscount Who Loved Me by Julia Quinn. It's probably the nicest cover that you'll see of the Bridgerton books. Anyway, this is Antony's storyline, which he is so much better in the books than he is in the TV show. Like in the first series of the TV show, he was kind of not nice, But in the books, he is a lot better. He is so lovely. He didn't want to make Daphne marry anyone she didn't want to, which is so lovely. Just putting it out there, Antony is amazing. Anyway, this is his love story, which I do love a good enemies to friends to lovers story. So that's what you're gonna be in for reading this one. Also, I think they have casted amazing people for the show, and I'm very keen to watch it. Yes, I am a little bit of a trash panda when it comes to romance, especially Julia Quinn. She is very problematic in some areas, especially in The Duke and I. And yes, well, they are period pieces, so of course they're going to be problematic in nowadays. But they're nice if you just want to put your mind away and read a nice trashy romance. There they are. And it is up against The Backstages. Here it is, The Backstages. Basically, it is about the, you know, the people in the wings of the show and how the actors are kind of a bit mean to them, but then also the backstage area is weird, like they go through doors and it just leads to a giant maze of strangeness. It's kind of in the same area of Lumberjanes, of weirdness, but it's also really fun as well. But yes, I enjoyed it. And so it's up against The Viscount Who Loved Me. I'm sorry, Backstages is being dropped. I will take this trashy romance and run. Thank you very much. And this is the final round. So we have Outlander. Here it is, Outlander. So this is basically a historical time traveling book, a novel. It's not, it's fictional. Why am I saying as if it's real? Anyway, it follows the story of Claire Randall slash Fraser, if you wanna give away some spoilers. Anyway, she falls through some stones and goes back to, I think it's 1743. So back when Scotland and England were kind of like fighting back then. And yeah, a lot goes down when Culloden is kind of, you know, building up. So it's very interesting and I really do like it. And it is up against The Giver. So I don't have The Giver on me. I think it's in storage. But basically is about a dystopian society who don't really have feelings or emotions. They just kind of exist. And it's kind of like after, like, I think what World War III would be. And they've just kind of been like, okay, if we take away emotions and if we just live in black and white, everything will be okay. But yeah, it's not, because they have no emotions, they have no empathy or anything like that. And so every so often they have to have a receiver of memory to remind them to be empathetic and do things in a certain way. And so we have Jonas, who is the main character in this book, and he becomes the receiver of memory, but learns that the society is kind of corrupted and not good, and he kind of runs off towards the end of the book to fix things. And that's kind of how it ends, and it's really nice. But I think I'm gonna have to pick Outlander because it's just amazing and I just can't say no to it, because yes. Anyway guys, that's all I've got for you today. Please like, subscribe, because it's always nice, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.